On the day of the occupation of Paris, the new German frontal attack began against the Maginot Line. Fighting planes and dive bombers attack an enemy fort with their heaviest and deadliest bombs. A direct hit on an enemy bunker. Heaviest artillery blasts the enemy line in preparation for the attack. Under cover of an artillery barrage, the German infantry forces the passage across the Rhine. Bunker after bunker is taken. This is the remainder of the Maginot Line. Numerous prisoners fall into German hands. Here are some defenders of civilization. During the battles, German combat planes dominate the air. Enemy airplane is shot down. On the north front, the German troops come nearer to the fort of Verdun. This fort, which was not silenced in the World War, falls into German hands after a short battle. Metz is occupied. Over the Strasbourg Cathedral waves the swastika flag. From his headquarters, the Führer with his generals leads the victorious operations. Thank you. the day at Compiegne. An assembly of troops. The Führer with his generals passes along in front of the guard of honor and salutes. In the railway car of Marshal Foch, in which the armistice was signed in 1918, the French commission for this armistice is awaited. With their leader, General Hunziker, the French delegation arrives. After reading of the preamble of the German conditions, the Führer leaves Compiegne. Here we see the actual signing of the armistice documents. It was done in the same historic car of Marshal Foch. The French government at Bordeaux, having agreed to the terms, on the 25th of June, at 1:35 in the morning, the fighting stops. In Germany, the flags of victory wave. The war on the European continent is ended.